Let us move to the next important function of management, directing. So directing is said to be the heart of management process, right? It's said to be a heart of management process. In simple terms, we can describe this directing as, it is a guidance given to the worker. So whatever we have planned, organized, staffed, everything will go waste if we don't direct the employees properly. So the manager work doesn't get over just by making a proper plan or creating the objective for an organization. They should also act as a motivator. They should also lead the subordinates, guide the subordinates, and also communicate with the subordinates. So let us move to the next important function of management, controlling. This function is very helpful to the management to evaluate the performance of the employees and also help the management to decide that which employee is doing better and which employee needs a training. Clear? So how to evaluate the performance of a employee? By comparing the actual performance with the predetermined performance. Clear, boys? So the next important function of management is coordination. In every organization, there will be various departments. For example, finance department, purchase department, sales department. So all these departments will work for a common objective of an organization. But all these departments should work together. They have different departments, they have a different kind of work, but all these will lead to a common objective. Ultimately, they are working for accomplishing the common objective of an organization. Let us move to the last main function of management, motivation. So motivation is a process of attempting to influence others to do your will through the possibility of gain or reward. Right? It can also be said as motivation means a process of stimulating the people. Here you are stimulating the people to action to accomplish the desired goal. Yes, so the manager should motivate the employees for increasing the speed of the performance and also to develop the willingness among the employees to work for an organization, right? The motivation can be given to the employees by giving the monetary or non-monetary incentives or through the effective communication or through the gentleman approach by the manager to the subordinate, they can motivate their employees. Have understood the concept of main functions of management, go through that page number 13 and 14 from your textbook. Thank you. Hope you have understood.